either we receive a statement from the minister now, or I lead my troops outside this chamber.
Following their walk out of parliament in protest yesterday, the leader of opposition, Mathias Simpuga, today chaired a caucus meeting of opposition legislators to forge a way forward as they continue to challenge government on arrests and continued violation of rights of opposition political actors. The opposition caucus resolved not to go back on the floor of parliament until the minister in charge of internal affairs tables a statement addressing their grievances. The opposition also stepped up their demands, asking government to apologize for the impunity which security forces meted against NUP members and supporters who had gathered at the party headquarters in Kamocha to pray for their departed colleagues on Independence Day.
We do not want to say much, but unless that statement is made, we shall not be in the house, including today. And when a commitment is communicated that the statement is going to be made, we shall return to the house.
However, today's meeting was only attended by NUP MPs plus FDC's Ibrahim Semujunganda. Mpuga explained why other opposition political parties are dragging their feet on the noble cause.
Whoever does not believe that this is a just cause, they have a right to associate with the oppressor. That's not our space. So ask them whether they agree with us. Then you give your viewers good news.
As the house gathered in the afternoon, the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Tayewa, acknowledged receipt of the letter from the Leader of Opposition demanding a statement from government. He directed the Prime Minister, Rabindranath Nabbanja, and the Minister of Internal Affairs, Major General Kahindo Tafiria, to present a statement tomorrow concerning the alleged brutal arrest of National Unit Platform leaders and supporters.
I should invoke my powers to require the Prime Minister to come with the Minister for Internal Affairs and make a statement with regard to the complaints which they raised yesterday. I therefore would like to inform the Prime Minister that tomorrow I'll put you on order paper to make a statement, and I will share with you the copy of the letter.
Meanwhile, a handful of opposition legislators from FDC, DP and UPC attended the sitting, including Maokota South legislator Yusuf Sebambi, who was designated as FDC party whip to replace the outspoken Kira municipality lawmaker Ibrahim Semujunganda. Sebambi expressed his gratefulness to parliament for finally accepting his appointment and promised to work well with everyone without praying for the gallery.
We'll work with all the other members, and my whipping is not like I'm a supervisor, but I'll try to ensure that at least we have common positions which meet or address the issues that affect society than just playing to the gallery.
NRM legislators welcomed in Sebambi with a loud applause, and the third Deputy Prime Minister, Lukia Nakadama, pledged a good working relationship with Sebambi.
Right, Honourable Speaker, I want to take this opportunity to congratulate Honourable Sebambi Yusuf for accepting to take that position and also assuring us that he is going to work with us and, of course, the members from his party. So we equally pledge on behalf of government that we shall work with you.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.